Your Berks Craftsmen on BCTV is supported by the Kutztown Folk Festival and by the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen.
Good evening, and I am Kay Bennecoff, your host of Your Berks Craftsmen, and tonight we are here with Heather Zimmerman. I just met Heather tonight myself, and so you are in for a real treat because we are going to learn all about the fantastic, the one and only, the Kutztown Folk Festival. And yes, it's live.
Thank you, Kay. Thank you for having me.
Oh,
and
absolutely.
Wanted to give you this little gift on behalf of the Folk Festival to thank you for having us on the show.
A gift from the Folk Festival? Well, I know what it's got to be. It's got to be funnel cake, right?
I wish. But
it's not funnel cake. You should always bring me funnel cake.
I know. Okay. I don't think the funnel cake would have made it from my car, though. So good.
Oh, my goodness. This was so nice of you. Well, it is a Kutztown Folk Festival t-shirt. Good enough to eat, almost. Go Dutch. Okay,
go.
That's perfect. Heather, thank you so much. Not as perfect as funnel cake would have been, but next time I will get funnel cake. And there's a wonderful pin. The Kutztown Folk Festival 2021.
That's right.
Haha. And
that's
what,
our fall fest.
Yes. And that's what we're talking about tonight, right?
Yeah,
I'm
right.
So excited. Oh my gosh. So is everyone. Everyone is excited. So I won't need these napkins. Okay. But next time I will.
Right. Exactly.
Okay. So Heather Zimmerman, this is your first Kutztown Folk Festival, right?
As director, it sure is.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yes.
She is the director. So how does that happen? How did that happen?
Well, my background is in hospitality. I've worked in the hotel business for over 30 years and was most recently working for the Hampton Inn and Suites in Kutztown.
Oh.
And got to know some individuals with our connection to the Kutztown Foundation. And they, through some discussions, this position was available, and they thought that they wanted someone to be the director who comes in with a fresh set of
eyes.
And just try to elevate and open up the festival to some new ideas and some new things down the road. So
yeah, and the new inn there is a big, it's a great thing, you know, for Kutztown College, for Kutztown itself.
Absolutely.
And especially for the Kutztown Folk Festival.
For sure. For sure. It's a perfect fit.
Yeah. How many rooms are there?
100 rooms.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
100 rooms, free breakfast, indoor pool.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the hotel, I believe, we opened in 2019, so we really never got to experience the Folk Festival. We opened after the 2019 festival. But... and then, of course, for the past 2 years, the hotel's been open, but no festival.
Mm-hmm.
So, but we anticipate the hotel, offering maybe some special rates and shuttle service back and forth to the festival and so forth. So, yeah.
Well, we as the Reading Berks Guild, we were able to offer to our patrons, and to our craftsmen in 2019.
That's right.
So, that was the first, just opened,
Absolutely.
And stuff. And so it was really nice.
We were thrilled for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we were.
So, okay. Well, tell us what's happening, okay?
What's happening? Okay. Well, there's lots of good things happening. I guess first and foremost, I'll just mention that the Kutztown Folk Festival will be happening live in 2022. The dates are July 2nd to the 10th.
July 2nd to the 10th.
Mm-hmm. This will be our traditional summer festival that many people have been missing, sadly, for the past 2 years.
Yes.
But we're excited and we're very positive about this festival happening next year. So we cannot wait. Hope to see all our regulars and all the people who love the festival so much, and hopefully some new faces that learn to love it just as much.
Absolutely. Yeah, the last couple of years, it's been rated like the number two festival, in the United States.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
And
what an honor.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure they'll be back.
I hope so. I think the time is right. People are really getting out and about again and traveling and so forth. So it's the perfect environment. It's an outdoor event. So we're just hoping for some not so hot weather, but just nice weather.
It's the Kutztown Folk Festival.
It's going to be hot, right? But that's okay. We're going to have it. We're going to enjoy it. We're going to welcome, you know, we hope a lot more visitors. And maybe the past 2 years not having it has gotten people even more excited about the festival. So it's such a, you know, beloved event that I really feel like people cannot wait to get back out there. So.
Right. Well, and like you said, you know, well, or we talked about that, it's a huge festival, well known all over the United States, but especially endearing to the people in Kutztown, Berks County.
Of course, it's a local favorite. And one thing that I've learned since I came on board the end of June is just how many stories are really associated with the festival. I talked to someone who, you know, met their future spouse at the festival, or, you know, so many family memories, personal memories, things that really are near and dear to people's hearts. So we're just excited to be able to continue this event and create more memories for, you know, families and individuals attending.
Yeah. So this will be the 72nd,
yes.
right? You know, so you know, there 72 years, and so like there's a lot of stories behind
that. Lots of stories, and lots of very loyal and committed vendors, helpers, volunteers. I'm surprised. I talked to two people just in the last 2 days who have been involved with the festival since its inception, 72 years ago.
We have one of our members.
Okay, that's fabulous.
I'm just going to do a shout out. Elaine Vargin, you know who you are.
Well, right. So it's, to me, that just says so much and about the love and you know, the memories and how sentimental and nostalgic this festival is for so many. And we just really want that to continue and bring that to generations to come.
Mm-hmm. And I think, you know, with, you know, the way it's been going, do you remember the resurgence of crafts back in 1976 when the United States celebrated their 200th anniversary? And I think that brought on, I think that's what's going to happen with this.
I think so too.
You know, the resurgence, you know, and everything, and the family orientation, you know, I came to the festival, you know, 50 years ago, and I want to bring my children and
my grandchildren. Well, and I think also it's more about, it's, you know, we don't want to be a craft show with food. So
we're not that. You are not that.
And I really feel that people now more than ever, and perhaps this is something that COVID taught us, that, you know, with being more isolated from family and friends, is that how important those experiences are. So, and that closeness. So we feel as though this is a great opportunity to come out and learn more about the Pennsylvania Dutch culture, the educational opportunities that are at the festival, as well as the fabulous food, the amazing and talented craftspeople, the entertainment. So we really think that this provides a complete experience for people.
Yeah. So I think a good word is like a living history.
Absolutely.
You know, I mean, you know.
Of course.
And so it's all mixed in there, you know,
sure
the fun.
Is.
And so kids are learning and they're not learning in the traditional way.
They don't
you know?
Even know they're
they
learning.
They don't know
they're having
learning.
Fun. right.
And that's the main part.
That's
you
exactly
know?
Right.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. And but they do have that wonderful schoolhouse, on the grounds. And they conduct the classroom. And the kids get to sit at the desks and stuff, and it's a good.
Those authentic experiences mean a lot to people, and I think it's really neat to carry those traditions on.
Mm-hmm. And it's good to know that we're telling everyone tonight that it's going to be just like that again. But we're getting down to the good part here. Okay, they don't have to wait.
No, you do not have to wait. The great news is we are, the Kutztown Folk Festival, we would like to expand beyond our traditional 9-day festival and do other events throughout the year, because why just make it one time, you know? Why not, you know, extend the fun? So we started this year. We did not want to wait too long to have another reason to get together and to see our loyal visitors. We're going to have a Fall Fest this October. So, yes, October 13th to the 25th, we have a variety of different things going on. I don't know if we can share my screen
here. Oh, yeah. You want to share the screen now?
Yeah,
we certainly will do that. You know, let's get these important. Oh, my gosh. There it is.
There it is.
Fall Fest on Main. And I'm just going to say live.
It is live. It is live and in person. Yes. So, again, you know, it says it right here, the Folk Festival is going to look a little bit different. This mm-hmm. is a smaller version. We kind of tried to do some different things mm-hmm. and try our hand at that a little bit to give people some new experiences, but still kind of fall under the Folk Fest theme and feel.
Yeah.
So we'll just continue down, and we're going to kick off. One of the things we're going to do, and I should probably back up just a little bit, we're going to offer a passport to downtown Kutztown. And the passport to downtown Kutztown can be purchased on our website at kutztownfestival.com. It will cost $10. And we have a collection of local merchants, Kutztown merchants. You can take your passport into their shop anytime during the week of October 13th to the 17th. They will stamp your passport, and once your passport is completely stamped by all the vendors that are listed, you can turn that in to our quilt store, which will be located, we're doing a temporary quilt store on Main Street.
Okay.
You can turn in your completed passport, and you will be able to win a quilt worth up to $1,000. So I think that's a fantastic way to cap that week. So we're hoping that we'll also, we really want to incorporate our Kutztown neighbors and get the local merchants involved and make sure that when people are coming to Kutztown, they're experiencing like our whole area. So I feel this is a good way to get them downtown.
Okay.
So.
Now let me ask a question. You said you can go online, you know, but can you buy the passport anywhere in town too?
Right now we're doing it just online.
Just online.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we're doing it just online at the moment.
Okay.
Okay. Then up on the screen here we have, this is brand new for us. We're really super excited about this. We are having a farm-to-table dinner.
Wow.
We're partnering with Rodale and hosting the event there. It's going to be from 4:30 to 8:30 on Thursday, October 14th. It's going to include a wagon ride to the Garden Pavilion.
I know.
We're doing it up.
And, my goodness, that's awesome.
So there you'll be greeted with by Blue Mountain Vineyards. They'll be hosting a wine tasting starting at 5. And then we would love for you to stroll back to the barn where you'll have dinner. And the dinner is by Dundore and Heaster. It's a fabulous dinner, full course dinner. We're also going to have a collection of hand-selected local artists and craftsmen who will be available there. And it's going to be a very intimate setting, so our guests at the farm-to-table dinner can interact with the craftsmen and ask questions, and they can also purchase. And then we're going to have a fabulous take-home dessert. And I know, because we kind of feel like it might be a little full after the dinner. So take home dessert, and also the fire pit will be open. People can go back there and they could maybe eat their dessert if they don't want to take it home, and have another glass of wine and just enjoy the evening. So super excited about that.
Well, that's brand new. That's very awesome. So now where can they...
This will be a ticketed event.
Yeah.
Tickets will go on sale August 1st, and that will be on our website at kutztownfestival.com.
Okay.
So, again...
I'm taking notes, too. You know, I have
to. Fabulous event. Fabulous event. We're super excited about that.
Well, that is... And talk a little bit about Rodale, because they are just a really good...
It's a perfect partner for this. The grounds are so beautiful.
They're just beautiful.
And their dedication to, you know, anything and everything organic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So we felt that this was a great partnership for the festival and part of what we're about. And, you know, obviously we want to incorporate the community. So this is just the perfect location, something that they're familiar with doing and hosting events, of course.
Yeah.
So they could not have been more gracious and, you know, welcoming us for this event.
It's a great partnership.
It really is. We really value all the insight they've given us, because this is our first time planning something like this. And, you know, we certainly hope to continue to have these type of events.
Well, and they're very good at that.
Oh my goodness. Yes, we dream about what that event's going to look like. You know, we can only imagine this, you know, how scenic it will look, or, you know, the setting is and how beautiful it will be.
Okay. Now, will that be a limited number of?
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So,
yep.
So you got to get there.
Get online. August 1st. Yes. August 1st. We will do our best if, let's say, there's someone, a group of people who would like to be seated together. That we can note that and, you know, do our best to accommodate people. We anticipate everybody being at this really long, you know, series of long farm tables.
Yes.
But we will do our best to accommodate any kind of special requests if need be. So.
Okay. And so you don't know how many you can accommodate there. I'm just saying, you know.
Right.
Get these people online.
Yes. Right. It's going to be about 100 people.
100.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Right.
So it 100 is, tickets.
100 yeah, 100 tickets, tickets. Yes. So it is limited, you know, but what a beautiful event should be.
I know, we're so excited about that. Yeah. And I think it'll be a big hit,
and
a beautiful time of year. It should be a lovely evening for everyone.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
All right. Well, that will roll right along.
So excited already. I'm getting goosebumps.
Buy your tickets August 1st. The next event, well, this just is a little highlight about the passport again.
Again,
visit the merchants in town, have them stamp your passport, and then the completed passport can be turned in to win a quilt. So the winner will be selected at the quilt store on October 17th.
Okay, very good.
And the quilt store, it will be located in the 200 block of Main Street in Kutztown.
Okay.
We're doing a temporary storefront there.
We're going to say that again. We'll say that again.
We'll say it multiple times. And that's all on our website, too. We'll have plenty of details.
Yes. And this is on your website, just as we're showing.
Sure.
So, I mean, so you're just giving us all the little extra highlights here.
Yes. We'll just highlight it.
Very good to know. Yeah, absolutely. Okay.
Next, so we'll jump down, obviously, the quilt store. So that is going to be open from October 13th to the 17th. It's open for in-person sales and viewing. So you can walk in the store, you can view the quilts, you can talk to Carol and her team there who handle our quilt barn.
Okay, so Carol will be there.
Yeah, yeah. So it'll be very informative.
Now, where is that? Do you have the address to the quilt store?
I don't have the specific number, but I know it'll be in the Horst building, H-O-R-S-T, the Horst building, which is in the 200 block of Main Street in Kutztown.
Okay, and those dates again on that?
That is October 13th to the 17th.
Okay.
I guess we could just talk more about the quilts. Because,
yeah, please.
So from the 13th to the 17th, that's where the quilt barn store will be open on Main Street, where somebody will be a lucky winner on the 17th, somebody who turned in a completed passport. And then we're going to have a quilt auction preview week. And that is going to be from October 19th to the 25th. And that will be located at the Hampton Inn in Kutztown. And visitors will be able to view a selection of quilts that will be available in our online quilt auction, which will occur on October 25th.
Okay, but that's online then.
That's correct. Okay. The auction will be online.
Okay. Now that says conducted by Zettelmoyer. What does that mean?
He's the auction house that will be doing who manages the auction for us.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, I mean, he's not going to be...
He's not going to be out there with a microphone
doing
that. It's all online.
Yeah, I just wanted to clarify that for people because
it's all
online. To see that. So it is just, it's online bidding.
It is.
So, you know,
and we tried that when we first had to not have the festival.
Yeah.
It was very successful.
Yeah,
so,
it worked out well.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah, so we're going to try.
Yeah, so it is going to be like that. I just wanted to clarify because it says conducted by Zettelmoyer Auction.
It's not live.
Yeah.
It's online.
Yeah.
But the viewing, obviously, you can come in and preview these quilts in person at the Hampton Inn that entire time.
Right, so that'll be there. Yes, perfect.
Yeah. Okay. So then we have that. And then we can jump down to the next thing would be fabulous fun event, Square Dancing on Main Street, which is a free event, and it's Friday, October 15th. Start or end your night, and we have a beer garden. The Main Street restaurants will be open. We're going to have some dessert vendors there that night.
I hope there's going to be funnel cake.
I think it would probably be a bad idea if we didn't have that. Right, exactly right. Of course, Lester Miller and his family of square dancers, along with Keith Brinsenhoff, will be entertaining from 7 to 9 p.m.
And 7 to 9 that yeah. is then. Okay.
And we are encouraging, we went dancing in the street. So if you're into square dancing, you should come to this event and have a good time. Families, you know, couples, whatever it might be, we would love for you to be there.
Okay. So now, is Lester bringing some of his family? Because he is a well-known person at the folk festival.
Sure is.
Okay.
Yes,
has that big stage. Oh my goodness. Yes.
Yes.
Everyone knows Lester.
That's right. We're so thrilled to have him there. And of course, Keith Britzenhoff as well. And
oh yes, Keith.
We can't. Should be a super fun night. Absolutely. Lots of entertainment.
Oh yes.
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 And so it would be a great night to bring the family out and, you know, have a great night out in the street, having a good time.
Okay, so that is going, you said 7 to 9.
That will be the entertainment.
Okay.
We would love for you to come to Main Street and eat dinner. Mm-hmm. And hang out and grab a beer. Saucony Creek Brewing Company is going to be doing a beer garden.
Oh, okay.
So we would love for you to eat, drink, and be merry.
Okay, so that's going to be, now, what area is that going to be?
This is all in the 200 block of Maine.
The 200 block. So that's that's the place to be.
That's the place to be.
Just have
that's
to remember right. 200 block
200
of
block.
Perfect. Okay. So Lester and Keith together, that is, you don't need anything more.
What else do you need, right? I know. We covered everything, I think,
entertainment-wise.
So.
Well, I know you haven't met Lester yet.
Okay. I've not met him yet. No.
Okay. But he has, I don't know how many are in his family, but he has his children, his grandchildren, his great-grandchildren.
That's awesome.
And they're just the most adorable.
Well, we expect Lester and his family. So we're not sure exactly who all is coming, but we expect the whole, you know, his family, his entourage to come along. So it should be a great night.
Oh, yeah. Well, then maybe you might have to move into the 300 block.
It could very well be. It could very well. And you know what? That's totally fine. So.
Oh, my gosh. Well, they are certainly a favorite at the folk festival. And so. Everyone will be
we're
so glad
to have them here.
Oh, yeah. But then I think you said that we're going to be able to do a little square dancing ourselves.
We encourage
dancing
it.
In the streets.
Dancing in the streets. We encourage it. We would love to see that. We would love to see everybody having a really good time and just really enjoying themselves and being outside and you know, going to the restaurants and shopping and having a good time.
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah,
it's gonna be very perfect. Okay, sounds great.
Then,
Heather, you're doing a great job.
Oh, my goodness. Okay. Well, thank you. I feel very famous tonight.
Well, you are very famous.
Thank you. And that brings us to, this is another ticketed event. It's a Dutch hex sign bike tour. This will start at the Pennsylvania German Cultural Heritage Center on Saturday, October 16th. Your ticket would include a map of the back roads where you can ride and see the beautiful hex sign art with some explanations as to what you'll be seeing.
Okay.
We're doing a swag bag, so that will be filled with a really cool t-shirt, and we're working on getting some other really neat little items in there.
Oh, okay.
And the tour will end at Saucony Creek Brewing. So
you need a beer.
You need a beer. Yes, you need a beer. So we would like you to drive further than the Cultural Heritage Center than to Saucony. We want it to be a real tour, not just a few blocks, but it should be a great tour.
That was just my husband.
I know, but he hit it on the head. I was happy. I bet people will wonder about that.
Pointed out that was a pretty direct route.
That was very direct. So,
but you don't want to do that route because you want to see the beautiful land.
Absolutely.
You know, the hex signs
of
are
course.
Out there.
And Patrick Dunmoyer from the Pennsylvania German Cultural Heritage Center does, an amazing job and is so passionate about the Pennsylvania Dutch culture. So we are working on a map and, information that will be helpful as people are doing this tour. So we're just really excited to see that finished product and get that in the hands of the attendees because we really think that's going to be special. So
that was a very good idea, you know.
Thanks.
So whose idea was that? That was great.
You know, well, you know, I have to give credit to mm-hmm. the team, Linda Ernst, who okay. is the office manager for the Kutztown Folk
She's
Festival.
Awesome.
She worked with Sandy Green with Kutztown mm-hmm. Community Partnership, and they actually really put this all together. So it was a group effort with you know getting input from other places and
yeah.
commitments from other places,
yeah.
but. I was lucky. I came on board the end of June, and this was already put together. just get to talk about it.
Yeah. Well, and that's an important job.
Yeah, I can do the talking. They did all the hard work yeah. and all the ideas, and I think these ideas are fabulous templates for us to possibly use for future events.
Oh,
you know, we can expand on these.
Yeah, and it's so in line with the festival.
Sure.
I mean, it is. Just in keeping with, you know,
we try to give a little bit of everything. Obviously, keep the food aspect, which is huge.
Yeah.
The crafts, you
yeah.
know, people aspect and
yeah.
so forth. But, I mean, even this is an outdoor opportunity.
Oh, yeah. This is the environment.
Sure.
You know,
yeah.
That, you
know, plus, it's a little bit of learning in there. So,
oh, absolutely.
Which is, you know, we're committed to you know, really celebrating that Pennsylvania Dutch culture. So this fits
yeah.
in.
Yeah. Yeah. We're proud of it. And so.
We're proud.
Yes.
Right. Okay. All right, so that's that. That is a ticketed event. Again, tickets go on sale August 1st, and it'll be on kutztownfestival.com.
Yeah, that's easy to remember, kutztownfestival.com.
Festival.com.
I mean, as soon as you almost type it in, it like
that,
brings
come
you
right
up.
Oh,
it does.
It should come right up. And then this is our one of our final events. It's the Fall Fest on Main. So this will be Saturday, October 16th, and we are saying Fest with the Best on Main Street.
That's good. I like
with
that.
The best. This is a mini festival. So
okay.
we're going to have, you know, a collection of craftsmen, artists, food vendors, restaurants, and downtown merchants will be open.
Okay.
There's going to be entertainment. So it'll be a day festival along White Oak and Main Streets in Kutztown.
Okay, so that's White Oak and mm-hmm. Main, not just limited to 200 block.
It's mostly, it really is. So this, again, this is a free event to attend. It's 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. There's also a Kutztown University home football game that day.
Whoa.
I believe there is a train show at Renninger's that day. So we expect Kutztown to be hopping. And gives everybody a chance to do something after the
yeah.
game or beforehand and go to Renninger's and then, you
yeah,
know, come
that's
here.
That's good for everyone involved.
Yes,
you know,
we would love to promote the area.
Oh,
so.
Yeah. Because Renninger's is a great, you know, a great venue there.
Oh, my goodness,
I mean,
yes.
You know, there's,
absolutely.
You know, we, as the Renning Berks Guild, we partnered with them most recently in the last couple of years, and Jim's just a great guy to work
Fabulous.
With, you know, and
yes.
stuff. So,
and
they always have fun events out there.
Oh yeah,
you know? And who can you're not going to mess with Kutztown football?
that's a given. Yes, you have to have the Kutztown football, and we're hoping for a win. So,
oh yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that better go without saying.
Right. Well, I mean, we're having the festival; it has
right,
to
right,
win. So,
right.
Yeah. So, I mean, that's sort of what we have going on this fall. We could not be more excited about it.
Mm-hmm.
We think it's just going to be a really neat way to, again, you know, not go a full calendar year without having our festival friends with
yeah,
us. So.
I think that was very important
I think
to
so
do,
too.
You know, because
I agree.
it tells the people that, yes, we are out. You know,
oh, my gosh.
You know,
and how much we value them.
And how much you committed to this. I mean,
sure.
You know, I mean, the whole organization of the Kutztown Folk Festival is, you know, I mean, this is kind of like, it is like a thank you to the people that come, you know, that's
yeah.
what I feel, you know, I feel
right.
that, you know,
right.
and a thank you to the vendors, you know, like, because it's a big part of their life. I mean,
sure
vendors and craftsmen, especially, I'm going to say the craftsmen, I mean, vendors are probably a little more local, but the craftsmen come from all over the United States.
They sure do.
You know?
And that's a big commitment. 9-day festival is a big time commitment. We certainly, you know, recognize that absolutely and are so grateful for so many being willing
mm-hmm.
to commit that type of time to
mm-hmm.
our festival and to the success of the festival. What's kind of nice about this opportunity in the fall is that this opens us up for maybe some smaller craftsmen and
yeah,
vendors
who
may not have 9 days to commit
right.
to a festival, but they want to be involved
mm-hmm.
and they would love to be associated with the Kutztown Folk Festival. So
Okay, so if you are a craftsman, they can just get in touch with you as well to try to sign up for that? Okay.
Yes.
So what website should they?
KutztownFestival.com. Okay. KutztownFestival.com. They can also call us at 610-683-1537. There's a vendor application. It does cost $100 for the entire day to have a space. And we will heavily promote on social media. Mm-hmm. So far, our social media results have been very, very positive. People are very excited. They love the time of year.
I was going to say, that is certainly working
big plus,
for you. Yes.
Big plus. So, again, you know, really just trying to get people excited about Kutztown mm-hmm. in our area. And we would love for everybody to come out and have a good time.
Yeah. Well, I think they're, well, everyone's ready for a good time.
All the time. So, yeah, I don't think you can go wrong.
Yeah. And the, like we mentioned this a little bit before, the people in Kutztown, this is their festival, mm-hmm. right? The people who live there and who work there. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're very loyal to it.
Oh, my gosh.
I mean,
and have devoted countless hours and days.
They volunteer.
And
so many people volunteer.
Of course.
Know, to, you know, to help out with the festival.
Couldn't do it without them. So that's so important to us. And for us to, you know, acknowledge and honor that it is our community's festival. Mm-hmm. And we really, you know, part of what we want to do going forward and our vision going forward for the festival is to really be very inclusive of mm-hmm. our community and our region and highlight that because mm-hmm. we have so much to offer and we have so many talented people, you know, who could be vendors or craftsmen. But in mm-hmm. addition to that, we have so many people who are so committed to this area and their hometown and devote all these hours. You know, we owe it to all those people to make mm-hmm. this a success mm-hmm. and keep it going.
Yeah, and it is important for the heritage, you know.
Absolutely.
I mean, you know, it keeps it alive, you know, when we're torn in so many different directions, mm-hmm. you know, in our mm-hmm. lives today, mm-hmm. you know, and stuff. So it is a very good day to, you know, you have that smartphone, but you can just put it, you know, in
and
the pocket.
And step back in time.
Yeah, and step and back
at,
in time.
Yeah, celebrate the heritage, celebrate the culture. As I said before, we're not a craft show with food. We're like basically kind of a living museum.
I think so.
A celebration of that culture. Mm-hmm. And that makes us very unique. So we want to keep that. You know, that is central to everything we do. So even though we may look for opportunities to expand and do different things, honoring that is at our core. So that will never change.
Yeah. I mean, that's what helps to make it unique.
Unique, for sure.
I mean, we're not likening it to the living museums like Sturbridge or Williamsburg, but it is kind of like that, you know, in a mini way, mm-hmm. you know, I mean, you know, that week, you know.
And we still have those elements of the educational aspect of it, but then you can go get some fabulous funnel cake and you can go buy, you know, a handmade quilt. Mm-hmm. I mean, those opportunities are amazing.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah. Well, yeah, the people come from all over about the, you know, that quilt auction on that last Saturday of the Kutztown Folk Festival.
Sure.
So that would... Maybe that's a question that we can, and maybe you don't know the answer, or maybe you do. They're going to have all these quilts, you mm-hmm. know, and so, but the quilt auction, you know, like when the festival happens, you know, starting July 2nd of 2022, mm-hmm. they will have that big quilt barn again,
oh,
right?
Oh, sure. You know? Oh, absolutely. Oh, yeah. I mean, preparations were already thinking, yes,
yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah. So this was all in preparation for 2021.
Sure.
So there will be plenty of quilts to go around.
Quilts are not, yes. We're you know, Carol is always scouting new quilters and new designs.
Yeah.
And this I brought with us tonight is a log cabin design, which she says is a very traditional quilt.
Let's talk about that a little bit. You brought that over.
Yeah.
That's going to be one of the quilts on sale.
I believe so.
I think this is one of
the ones for the fall. I know she has curated a few, you know, special ones that we want to include. But yes, we're always looking for new designs and new quilters and new inventory. And of course, that is always available though for purchase online. So regardless of the auction, regardless of any kind of in-person event, you can always go to KutztownFestival.com and purchase a quilt at any time.
But with the fall festival, it's nice because so many people just love to come in person and see those.
We can't beat that experience.
Right. So you are giving, you know, with the fall festival here, you're giving them two opportunities, you know, two different venues, you know, to do that.
And that's so central to the festival. It's such a, you know, a loved and cherished event, or, you know, portion of the festival is the quilt.
Oh yeah.
So, you know, and we have people from all over the world, as you say, that you know, come or, you know, buy our quilts. And you know, we ship quilts out every week from the sales online, and it's always interesting to see how far they go. You know, some of them go quite far.
Yeah, shipping great distances. It's fun to, like, I check the website every week.
And
see the different quilts. You know,
It's amazing.
Yeah.
The craftsmanship.
You certainly do appreciate all the hard work that goes into it.
It's almost like I really can't. I mean, I'm fortunate enough, my office, I share with all the quilts. It is a storage area for
some of the quilts. Isn't that just nice?
You know, I think of it as a huge plus, because I'm surrounded by all this beauty and talent and craftsmanship every day. So I'd love to see when we're photographing new ones. It's really exciting to see the designs. And so, yeah, I think it's very... It's an honor.
Yeah. And then working with Carol, she's so
fun. Yeah. We have a great team.
Oh, my goodness.
We have a great team. We really do. And so many talented and insightful and supportive people. But more than that, the experience, you know, the depth of experience and wealth of experience that these people bring to the table, it really astounds me.
Yeah. So it's a learning experience. I mean,
for sure. Absolutely.
You're learning about doing this, but you're learning so much more than that.
And it's fascinating. Yeah. It really is. Yeah. It's an honor.
That's very cool.
Thank you.
Okay. So then, so we finished up that the auction quilt is preview by invite. What does that mean exactly?
That is going to be some people that are... there's a special preview night that will be the night before... It's the Friday before the actual live quilt auction. Those are some selected craftsmen and quilters, and some people important to that world are going to be invited to a special preview night. So may not necessarily be, it's not going to be open to the public that evening.
So that night's not.
A little bit special. So we're trying to, you know, kind of do something a little extra for those people.
For those people involved in that.
Right.
Okay, so that's very nice. And then October 25th would, technically that would be then the day to that they would go.
The online auction.
So that.
And Zettel Moyers will be handling, coordinating all that for us.
Trying to figure that out.
I know, there's a lot going on. We have a lot going on.
I had to take notes.
I have my notes right here.
Yeah, you do, but I needed to add to mine so that I can pass that on, you know, because there's so much good stuff, you know, happening.
Thank you. We think so, too.
Yeah. Okay, so let's just say about the passport then. What are the passport? Can we just review those and say what are the events that they would need this passport for?
So the passport, let me get to, the passport is an item. It's a it's a card they can purchase online. It'll be $10 per passport.
Okay.
On the back of the passport will be an area where you can fill out your name, email, and so forth. And then there will be a logo for, I think we have six or seven merchants downtown. You would go visit that merchant, and you would get your passport stamped at that merchant. Once the passport is completed, you would go to the quilt store, which will be on Main Street, drop in your completed passport, and then on October 17th, we're going to draw a winner.
Okay, so that is the main purpose. But they do need it. They do need to have it stamped.
They do.
Those six merchants.
I would say it's a dual purpose. So one of the main, we want someone to win a fabulous, beautiful, handcrafted quilt. But the other idea is that we really want people to go downtown and shop and eat in our local merchants. So We have some really cool ones on the passport. Mm-hmm. We think we have a nice little collection of people who, merchants who were willing to be on it with us. And so we're hoping that, you know, individuals will go buy the passport and give them a reason. Hey, I'm going to go in here and get this stamp, but I also want to go,
and,
you know,
sure,
buy some jewelry or buy a scarf or uh-huh. eat some donuts. So mm-hmm. I want to give away names because I want it to
that's
be a surprise.
Okay. That's okay.
But that's what we're hoping. So we really want to drive traffic into the
Okay, I wanted
street.
To reiterate
sure.
on that because we touched on it in the
Absolutely.
Beginning, but we didn't really, get the whole picture on
yeah.
that. Okay.
Yeah.
So, so you need to just go online and purchase that passport, and that'll be fun. Well, I don't know what to say. This is like, I just want to go every day.
I hope you do. And tell your friends. Tell everyone. We really feel like this is a really nice selection of events that really, I can't imagine that someone would not find something that they would really love.
Right.
And
even if you can't do that you can't be there every day, there are a few days that you might
sure.
be able to, you know.
Absolutely. Of course you can.
And you've made a very nice, it's almost a 2-week period, that you've done that, with there. So I think Kutztown is going to be a jumping place, like you said,
and that's certainly
what, you're hoping for.
Right.
And mainly, just so people know, Kutztown Folk Festival is back.
It's back. We're back. I know there was some concern, obviously, and, I rightfully so. I mean,
sure.
we've had a rough 2 years, as many other festivals and events have experienced as well. The first year it was completely out of our hands as far as what we could do in 2020. 2021, there was too many ifs, and that is a decision that needed to be called fairly early.
Sure.
Because of the extensive planning and setup and everything of the festival, not to mention we owed it to our vendors and craftspeople and food vendors and everyone. They needed to know what we were doing because early enough so that if they needed to make arrangements to be at a different event so that they could make money, we wanted them to do that. So we had to make a call.
Right.
And unfortunately, that, we wanted to make a decision on and err on the side of caution.
Yeah.
And I think it was good. It was the right thing to do at this point. But now that just gave us more time to get geared up for 2022.
Well, right. And this is a brilliant way of getting back in the groove.
We don't want to get rusty. So this is great. And we know it's like Kutztown Folk Festival on the road. So we love that we're taking it some other places.
Yeah.
We want to be, we can expand beyond the footprint of the fairgrounds.
Oh, yeah.
And again, it's all about including our community.
Mm-hmm. And I also like the part about, especially with the Pennsylvania Dutch Hex Sign Bike Tour, especially people from out of town or that aren't realizing about the heritage center there. And so they're gonna get a little peek at that in that, because the heritage center does wonderful events throughout the year as well. And again,
they do. Patrick's a treasure and a wealth of information, and again, so passionate about Pennsylvania Dutch culture that I feel anyone who signs up for this bike tour, the map that you get and the information you get about these barn stars and the hex signs, and which I've learned are interchangeable. I think it's going to be a really great event, and so scenic. But also some education,
a wealth
too.
Of knowledge. And just pretty.
Pretty. Yes, for sure. Yes.
And the barn stars or the hex signs, whatever, that is such an integral part of the festival.
Oh, it is.
I mean, we have so many talented artists and craftsmen who do reproduce hex signs at the festival.
Of course.
And and so taking this bike tour, you're just going to get some exercise, and
you're going to get some exercise before you end up at Saucony Creek
growing
at the end of the tour for a beer and some. Hopefully, they make amazing Brussels sprouts. So we're trying to work up a beer and Brussels.
Oh, there you go. Oh, okay.
So it's somewhat healthy, but get your bike ride in first. But so it should be a really fun day. And then people who want to, the festival will be going on down on Main Street.
Yeah,
they can also bike ride down to Main Street and have some more fun.
That would was brilliant to put that, you know, to put that together.
The team did a fabulous job doing that and tried to really be thoughtful and concerned about what people would want to do and really tried to develop events around that.
Yeah. Well, and then right after that, right after all of this wonderful folk festival in October, BCTV will be celebrating their Oktoberfest on the 25th. So that's a big event for BCTV. It is a lot of our craftsmen donate to that, you know, and that is an auction, you know, online, you know, and that night. And well, it's online and that night in person and in the studio. And well, it's a great event. And our craftsmen from the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen are very good supporters of BCTV and the Kutztown Folk Festival. So many of our craftsmen do the festival. So we're glad you're back as
Thank you.
And then I'm just going to say that Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen is glad to be back because we will be back on November 6th and 7th at Kutztown University for our 71st annual Juried Fine Art and Craft Festival. And we couldn't be happier about that either.
That's great.
You know, and fortunately this year in 2021, we celebrated an event for the first time out at Renninger's on May 1st. We had a, it was our craft event out there. So our craftsmen were so excited about doing that and we had such a wonderful day. We're doing it again next year.
That's great to hear.
Yep. So the first Saturday in May, we'll be back out at Renninger's. Back by popular demand.
Isn't that nice? That's great. Congratulations.
So, yes, thank you for that. And they're just so happy to be back.
So happy to be back. But both the people putting on these type of events plus the people attending. So I think there's a lot of opportunity. You know, now Kutztown has a hotel. We have the opportunity to bring more people in from out of town to experience what we offer. Come to some of these events and then also go see other attractions, other things in our area because we do have so much to offer. It would be a shame to miss that. I think being inclusive of the area and all that it offers is so important to us. And, you know, we're looking at even like helping and sponsoring at other festivals and so forth that go on because we have to work together. And, you know, I think if we can promote our area, you know, as a team and collectively, we all succeed. So,
And our
community succeeds because it brings money into our local economy. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah. And when we've done promotions for our own festival, you know, in the past, we have always tried to include, you know, what's in the area to do because, you know, if someone's coming up, you know, our event is a 2-day event, you know, and then you can go do some other things.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you know, there's so many wineries around, you know, that have come up. Crystal Cave, which that is a true delight.
It's a real treasure. It is a real treasure.
And if you don't get to do the bike event, you could follow that map and drive around the countryside.
We actually have somebody, an Instagram friend who said, is it possible for us to get the map and drive it? And I said, absolutely. So I do think we might have some people who either for whatever reason don't feel comfortable biking it, but would still like to know and still like to experience it. So that is absolutely totally okay. And we will make sure you get the map that you need to make sure you can do that.
Because those barns aren't going away.
No. And, you know, Patrick has been involved with restoring some of this barn art in some places. So it's going to be a special experience.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'll just throw this name out there too. Eric Claypool.
Oh, of course.
I mean, you know, because
you're going to see him at one of these events.
I would imagine not.
He's already been kind enough to commit to being at some of these events for us.
I'm sure. It wouldn't be the festival without Eric.
You are right. And speaking of which, we are still open to vendors. So if anybody is, I know it's a busy time of year, but I'll put a shout out there if anyone is interested.
Yeah.
We would certainly welcome new vendors for the day-long festival. Mm-hmm. Especially because we know that some people can't always commit to a longer period of time. sometimes a one-day event is a good fit, and we would welcome that.
Yeah. Okay, so say that website again.
It is kutztownfestival.com.
Okay, and then they can ask any questions to you on there.
They can go on there or call
us. And the phone number?
610-683-1537.
You'll get to talk to that lovely Linda, right?
Linda, yep. You might even get me sometimes. So,
but the lovely Heather as well.
Linda's even more lovely. So.
You're all lovely.
You're okay either way.
Yes, you're a delight to work with. It's been my pleasure.
Thank you. My pleasure to be here. Thank you.
So I'm going to have you back over the next several months here, and
we're
stuff.
We're ready. We would love that. Thank you so much. Okay. And thank you for the opportunity to talk about what we have coming up. And again, if I can just express that how much we really would love everybody to come on out and try us.
I know.
Yeah. I look forward to next July.
Yeah. I'm only sorry I didn't get... The funnel cake, but
I promise.
You're forgiven.
Next time.
Okay. So I want to thank everyone for joining us. You can go on bctv.org. We'll be up tomorrow. You're going to be on YouTube. This is going viral.
Oh, I'm going viral. Okay. All right. Exciting.
Okay. So thanks again, for joining us tonight, and we'll see you next time on Your Berks Craftsmen. And until then, take care, be safe, good night.
Your Berks Craftsmen on BCTV is supported by the Kutztown Folk Festival and by the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen.